Have you ever tried to catch a housefly? Well, every one of us would have tried it at least once, but most of the time, we don't succeed. They just fly away in a fraction of a second. How come they are so quick? Do they have some sort of sensors? What is it? Well, it is a curious and interesting question. Let's start with a simple experiment. Take a piece of stick or a pencil and hold it at the tip on one side and start jiggling the whole thing up and down slightly. When you do this, you might start finding at some point that the pencil is bending and may look like a rubber pencil. Well, is a pencil actually bending? No, it is creating an illusion of a curved line as if the pencil is bending, but in fact, it is plain and straight. To understand this better, we need to know two things, FPS and FFR. FPS is frames per second and FFR is flicker fusion rate. Frames are nothing but pictures or images. The movies that we see has a minimum of 24 frames per second, that is 24 images in a sequence, thus creating an illusion to us of the video instead of just having a still image. A typical human visual system requires a minimum of 24 images per second to make our brain believe that it is a continuous action. When the action is fast, the images are blurry, and in slow motion, it is much clearer. As the speed of the action increases, it becomes more and more blurry to the human eye. Example, a race car. Now, in order to have a clear video, movies started using much higher frame rates. The higher the frame rate, clearer the video is in terms of blurriness. There are lots of videos on the internet that demonstrates difference between a normal 24 FPS video and a higher FPS video, such as a 48 frames per second or 60 or 120 or even 1000 frames or even 100,000 frames per second. Now, we just mentioned that there are videos which has a higher frame rate of over thousands of frames per second or even higher. If so, why aren't we humans able to see them at a higher frame rate? Well, this is where it gets interesting. Let's just say our eyes and brains are not that good friends. Our eyes are similar to a camera. When light enters our eye, the eyes have receptors called rods and cones, which would carry and pass the signal to the brain, which is processed into an image. Now, for the brain to process every single image, these receptors has to carry the signals back and forth. Compared to some of the other living beings, we have a very slow visual system. For humans, the receptors can send signals around 50 to 100 times per second, which means 50 to 100 images are processed in our brain every second, which in turn means we are able to process only 50 to 100 frames per second. And this is called as flickering fusion rate, the number of times the eyes are able to carry the signal to brain. The typical human brain's flickering rate is 50 to 100 times. Now, that is also the reason why we humans are not able to find the difference beyond 100 frames per second. But whereas, some of the bird species can process up to 145 frames per second. The house flies can process up to 270 frames per second, and the fastest flies can process up to 400 frames per second. So technically, when we are moving very fast to swat a fly, we are actually moving in slow motion in the fly's perspective, which gives them ample time to take off easily. Well, hope we have answered your curiosity. If you do have any other interesting topics or questions, do let us know in the comment section below. We will catch you guys with another interesting video soon. Until then, it is Team DNA signing off and bye-bye.